What I would say to entrepreneurs in Europe is, first of all, believe in your own strength, because success critically depends on you as an individual. And of course, then the circumstances have to be right as well. The only thing that we have to achieve in Europe is to make sure we really grow to big entities also in the European setting itself. And it's your drive that is going to help, but it's also the responsibility of the people around you, in the industry, in the governments, to create the landscape and the conditions for you to successfully expand in Europe. And one digital market in Europe is the key thing to be established.
If we look, for example, at the world of the apps development is highly active in Europe, also very successful. And we see quite interesting software developments coming up in Europe that are becoming global successes.
Nowadays, it's completely different. The transaction cost, that is how much it costs to deliver something from one point to another, which includes also the innovation part, the creation part, has been dramatically lowered. So that basically today anybody can be in business.
This is a big collective societal work. So I'm not saying that it will happen just if we all sit back and relax and sleep or embrace blindly, but I think that we can embrace with confidence and shape these rules that will make our life good in a hyper-connected era. Because that's exactly what we are witnessing at the moment. The task of the day is to see how we define what it is to be together in this era where online and offline is blurring. There is no distinction anymore between online world and offline world. That's why we have proposed this on-life expression. But that's really a big, big shift that requires reframing a lot of concepts and rules and understanding of how we behave and what it is to be human in this era.
So what our commissioner Nelly Cruz wants is that the opportunities for young people are increased, that the enthusiasm is shown, that entrepreneurship is interesting for young people in Europe, and that we create an ecosystem that also enables them to do so, so that they are getting active in Europe and they also stay in Europe.
Take your efforts, concentrate on your goals, and keep telling the people that you need this one digital market to be established. And the people around will see your successes and will start to help you.
For me, the two advantages for being enterprises or public administrations migrating to the cloud are twofold. On one hand, cost, because they can reduce the upfront cost of using IT and they can concentrate in their own businesses and users instead of being concentrated in IT. And on the other hand, they can take advantage of the cloud benefits. For instance, scalability, they can just pay for what they are going to use and they can just use what they need. It's a way that public administrations and business companies that are not mainly focused in IT may significantly reduce their cost in the investment of in IT, and they can concentrate on their businesses, on their issues, instead of being concentrated in IT.
I think it's a great time to be an entrepreneur, particularly in the area of data right now, because the cost of entry is very low, so we can rent servers very easily. There's lots of data around to work with, and really the only barrier is good people. So I'd say find good people, find a business opportunity which excites customers that they're willing to pay for, and everything else is quite easy. Big data is, I think, a very big opportunity for SMEs and entrepreneurs. Obviously, not something that creates solutions by itself, but it's an amazing raw material which we can use to analyze and make sense of how things are working and to really build an accurate picture of how the world is and to try and predict what's going to happen next, which is very important for businesses and for government.
The Internet of Things is a really new and exciting area. I've been working in this area for the last 10 years, let's say, in EU projects and trying to promote the idea across Europe and globally as well. And I see huge potential for society to actually revel in this fantastic technology. Of course, like with any other technologies, that there are fears about its use and misuse. But essentially, I see that we can increase efficiency in our public and private sector. We can create new services that are useful for people to save time and money, to be more entertained, to live life more to the full. And I also see enormous potential for new business to be created out of the technology. So it will foster a lot of growth for the people that would like to take a risk with a new and disruptive technology.
Robert, we don't need to focus just on IoT per se. IoT is just, you know, a technology that allows us to do many other things. So when I think about it, I think about, you know, are there applications, for instance, on waste management because of IoT? Are there applications on traffic because of IoT? Are there applications in most of the fields? You know, we focus mostly on cities, so most of the urban fields, because of IoT. Well, it's not really about deploying IoT everywhere and then running apps. I think this is something that will happen little by little with different technologies. And then every different field will actually have its own investment case. So, you know, you can start looking at transportation. And then, you know, then you may have a smaller deployment in a city, and then that will actually yield benefits for the citizens in the city just for that. It's not about creating a huge infrastructure and then think about how to operate it. It's about kind of a much more bottom-up. Standard protocols and interoperability are really important things. And you know, we need to see how this is going to play out. There's probably different ways. Again, I really think the important thing is to keep things as much as possible as a kind of open bottom-up way and try to set standards, a little bit like the way it worked with the internet.
FIWARE provides the genetic enablers for Internet of Things, for clouds, for contents, for with the security requirements, etc., that will allow us to develop the applications of the future. So FIWARE for us is this basis on which we build ecosystems of innovation. It's an opportunity to bring web entrepreneurs and young researchers together with us in a movement that I would like to see spreading all over Europe and beyond. FILAB is available to the innovators that are in Lithuania, in Portugal, in Spain, but also the ones that are in Brazil or Mexico or in Korea. They can use it and they can make sense of that.
So if we see what FIWARE is producing, it is producing testbeds, enablers that can be used for development of new products and services.
What are the merits of this platform? First, is a platform that will offer to a large plethora of young entrepreneurs, of SMEs, or of professional developers, the opportunity to develop new applications.
Last week we had Cisco at the Internet of Things World Forum present that there's a potential $14.4 trillion in potential value in this industry. And I think he's not too wrong with it. The problem is maybe that we still see it too much locked into the different silos, looking at transportation, for instance, looking at healthcare, looking at logistics. They're all sitting within their individual silos. So if we really want to unlock this, we need to take a leap of faith, combining those industry sectors, making co-investments to actually get the most out of it. So I think now is the time to actually start creating applications that create confidence within the consumer side as well as the industry to see the potential of it.